negative aspect.
What is that animal he is holding?
It looks like a monkey. Many Native Indians keep monkeys for pets.
Oh my goodness! Hello there, little guy!
Keep that weird thing away from me! I bet it's got fleas!
Not if it's the tame monkey, which it looks like it is.
Forgive me, miss, but my monkey seems to have jumped through your window.
Indeed he has. I think he likes me.
I think he does.
I suppose you'd like him back, but though I must admit, I wouldn't mind keeping him.
My master would be very upset if his little pet did not return, but hopefully we'll be seeing you again soon.
I would like that.
My apologies again for the intrusion, and many thanks for catching this silly monkey.
That was a nice Indian gentleman. Why was he bowing like that?
It's called a salaam. It's an Indian sign of respect to one's superiors.
But we are not his superiors. We are servants, just like him.
I know. That was quite strange.
She will not return soon?
She is out and will not return for hours, and the other servant girl won't be back till late.
Well then, let's be about our business.
The bed, it's as hard as a rock, and the coverlet is dingy and warm.
What a bed for a child to sleep in a house that calls itself respectable!
The footstool is broken and the table is cracked. Floors need carpets and the walls are bare.
What a grand idea, Ramdas, to transform this room while she is sleeping tonight.
She is such an imaginative child. No one will enjoy the surprise more than she.
But do you think you can make all the changes while she is sleeping? Suppose she wakes.
I can move as though my feet are velvet. I can make all the changes. She would not stir. When she awakened, she'll think, a magician was here.
Oh, more radiant nights. Come here, Moss. Help me back through this weather. You have enough notes for now. In some ways, I am feeling stronger than I have in months.
My boy.
We like her so much. We call her the little fairy princess.
Well, why do you call her that?
A monkey's cat on her hands? Well, that's a good one.
And they applaud something like this.
Papa!
Hello, children. Papa, we missed you all.
What's the news? Did you find the child in Moscow?
She's not the child we're looking for.
Oh, no. I'm not feeling so well.
The child in Moscow is much younger than the child
on the stage in front of them, and they see
it. Her name is Emily Carew. I've seen Dan talk to her, and the delicious drives me every detail.
Well, It's too bad.
Any idea where to start? Any whatsoever?
Reality.
And I did encourage me on the journey here, that she could be right here.
I lived through it.
But there are plenty of schools in London. In fact, there's one right next door.
And we'll be in there. Where else could you go than next door?
No. There is a child there who interests me. She is not a pupil. She is such a forlorn creature, as unlike Ralph Crewe as any child could ever be.
You have to have seen it. No.
Sir, the child you speak of is very lovely.
She's only 100 years old.
Yes, she has. And she's carrying her monkey.
Why, yes, she is. How unusual.
Your
monkey ran away again.
Somebody's sitting here eating next to me for 45 minutes.
But I thought because you were ill that you might not want to be disturbed.
And I'm supposed to smile at that.
Should I give him to the Lascar?
How did you know that Ram Dass is a Lascar?
I know all about Lascars. I was born in India.
You were born in India? And you live next door?
I live at Miss Minchin's select summer.
But you were not one of her pupils.
At first, I was one of your pupils, and now I'm a scullery maid.
They haven't seen it, they've heard about it.
When I was brought here by my papa.
Where is your
father? He died and lost all his money.
Carmichael!
So, you at first were a pupil, but then you turned into a scullery maid. Is that it?
There was no one to pay Miss Minchin, and no one to take care of me. He had a friend he was very fond of, who took all his money and lost it.
But the friend may not mention to him. It just may have been a mistake.
Either way, my papa suffered and it ended up killing him.
Well, what was your father's name?
His name was Ralph Crewe, Captain Crewe. He died in India.
Carmichael, it is the child!
What child,
Lamar? I am your father's friend. We've been searching for you for months!
And I was right here, just on the other side of this wall.
So if I had just asked you what your name was when I gave you my sixpence, you would have been found?
So you are the wicked friend of my papa.
He is not wicked, my dear. He did not really lose your father's money. He only thought he did. And his grief mixed with the jungle fever made him so ill that he almost died of brain fever. And before he began to recover, poor papa died.
You did not know where to find me, and I was so near.
This really is too
real. When he saw you outside in the streets, he did not dream he was a child who was looking for. But because you were a little girl, wanted to make you happier, so he sent things.
So, did you and Ram Dass fix up my room?
Yes, my dear. We did it for our little lost Sarah Kerr.
Then you are my true friend.
Carmichael will be back in London in 3 weeks. You just look at his face already.
Carmichael, go next door and inform Miss Minchin that Sarah will live with me. My little missus has a loan for as long as she wants.
The truth.
Yes, sir.
Understand.
future will be with me.
With you? What does that mean?
I was a close friend of the late Captain Crew. Fortune, which he thought was lost, has been recovered, and now belongs to Sarah.
The fortune?
Certain events have increased Sarah's fortune. The diamond mines are prosperous.
The diamond mines?
There are not many princesses Mitch mentioned that are richer than your scholarly.
But she was left in my care. If it weren't for me, she would have starved in the streets.
As for starving in the streets, she was on her way to starving right there in your attic.
Mr. Crew left her in my charge. She is to return to my school and finish her education here.
I should think that that decision should belong to Sarah.
Then Sarah, I appeal to you. I may not have always spoiled you, but I know your papa would have been pleased with your progress. And I have always been fond of you.
Really? I didn't know that.
Mr. Carter, children never know what is best for them.
Yeah, that's all a big joke.
Me and Amelia have always known that you are the most clever child.
Oh,
will you not do your duty to your papa and come home with me?
You know very well why I'm going to come home with you.
What an ungrateful little wretch.
I'm not as clever as your sister, and I'm always afraid to say things for fear of making you angry. Perhaps if I were not so prudent, it would be better for the school and for both of us. I must say, I've often thought it would have been better if you had treated Sarah less severely and seen that she was more comfortable and decently dressed. I know you worked her too hard for a child of her age and left her only half fed.
How dare you say such a thing?
I don't know how I dare, but now that I've begun, I may as well finish. She was a clever child and a good child and would have repaid you for any kindness you had shown her, but you didn't show her any. And the fact is, she was too clever for you, and you disliked her for it. She used to see through us both.
Amelia!
She did. She saw that you were a hard-hearted woman, and that I, a weak fool, and that we were mean enough to grovel on her knees in front of her money, but behave ill to her because it was taken away from her. Though she behaved like a princess, even when she was a beggar.
Stop this instant!
And now you've lost her, and some other school will get her and her money. And if she were like any other child, she'd tell how she'd been treated, and then we'll lose all our pupils, and we should be ruined. And it's all your fault, Maria Pigeon, you hard, selfish woman!
You have not undertaken an easy charge, Mr. Carsford. You'll discover that soon enough. I suppose you feel like you're a princess again.
I tried to always behave like a princess, even when I was at my coldest and hungriest.
Now that your fortune has returned, it will not be necessary to pretend anymore. How lucky for you.
Well,
I'm glad that's over. Glad I don't have to go back there again. But might my friends be able to come and visit me? And what about Becky? She shouldn't stay in that horrible place.
Becky shall come over and live with us. And your friends? They can come over whenever you like. But this is your home, Sarah, forever and ever.
Oh, it's just like a fairy tale. And I am the princess who gets the happy ending.
You are my little princess, Sarah Crew, and you always will be.